we showed this clinical case of a patient who, in his left eye, presented an inferior temporal retinal branch artery occlusion. We will see the most characteristic signs of this entity. In this case, the arterial occlusion has occurred in the inferior temporal branch just before reaching the edge of the optic disc. With some difficulty due to edema, the embolus, the cause of the arterial obstruction, a Holland horse plaque, can be seen. The ischemic retina appears swollen, has lost its transparency, and acquires this whitish tone. It is easy to distinguish the boundaries between the edematous retina, due to acute ischemia, and the healthy retina. In this wide field retinography, we can see the area where the greatest amount of ischemical retinal edema is concentrated. Inferior and temporal to this area, we will also find acute parenchymal ischemia, although the retina is not so edematous. The layers of the retina where the edema accumulates are thinner the farther we are from the posterior pole. Being thinner, they will retain less fluid and show less edema, but the entire inferior temporal quadrant will be functionally affected. In this case, it is easy to distinguish an increase in perimacular venous tortuosity. What constitutes the Geist sign, which is related to hypertensive retinopathy? Here, we see a very characteristic sign of retinal arterial occlusion, and it is fractionation, intravascular fragmentation of the blood column. We can see bloodless areas that alternate with areas where the vessel still has blood content. This sign is the box-carrying or cattle track sign. We can also find completely bloodless vessels, the ghost vessels. In this area, we also see a pathological arteriovenous nicking. And in this more posterior area, closer to the optic disc, we can also see another arteriovenous nicking. Both are vein-related to the underlying hypertensive retinopathy in this patient. When the edema affects to the optic disc or the most immediate peripapillary area, a blurring of the optic disc margins will appear. And also an edema of the fibers that constitute the optic disc neuroretinal rim. We are going to complete this case by commenting on another pathology that it presents, and that is not related to arterial obstruction. Here, we have indicated with the arrow a part of the vise ring. Pathognomonic sign of posterior vitreous detachment. And we also see numerous heart drusen. Thank you so much for your attention.